Hello, viewers. We apologize for no video version of this because some idiot couldn't get us batteries.
You?
Anyways.
Why am I charged with the responsibility of getting batteries for your camera?
I don't know, but just be glad we're still doing this, okay? Maybe glad I thought of this.
I'll smack you in the face.
But anyways, my guest partner here is Taylor Riley.
Once again.
And let's just get down to business because this is going to be a super show. We're just going to be talking about wrestling news because we got a week worth of wrestling news right here and it's a page and a half. So here we go. Wrestling news. Hey. And we also apologize for being really quiet. It's like 10 o'clock at night and everybody else is asleep. Alright, the first news article is that former WCW superstar DDP, aka Diamond Dallas Page, believes that WWE should bring back the pay-per-view Halloween Havoc. It was basically WCW's SummerSlam and it held some of the greatest matches. One of them is to be DDP versus Bill Goldberg.
I disagree with this.
Why do you disagree with this?
They should not bring back Halloween Havoc.
Do you even know what Halloween Havoc was?
Nope, but they shouldn't bring it back.
Why shouldn't they bring it back?
Because I don't know what it is.
That's why you look it up.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Alright, and this is kind of late. I don't think this was like last week, but October 9th was Eddie Guerrero's birthday.
We should have thrown a birthday party.
Yeah, we should have. I mean, I didn't even know about that. I should have worn my shirt, but I didn't. Stupid me.
Idiot.
Yeah, but paying homage to Eddie Guerrero. Happy late birthday. Sorry.
Well, he's dead.
Doesn't matter. He can still hear us.
Can he?
Don't start with that.
All right.
Anyways, next article. Former WWE and TNA superstar Tyson Tomko, a.k.a. known as Goat Boy.
Goat Boy.
Chris Jericho called him that all the time because he had a beard that, like, came from here to here.
That's just racist.
And Mr. Tyson Tomko just recently got arrested on the charge of a robbery.
That's interesting.
The place he robbed was the pharmacy.
All right, that's just bad.
Yeah. Out of all the places, you pick a pharmacy. And I thought a gas station was the lowest place to go.
Idiot.
And also, Mr. Riley, this next news article will depress you.
What?
Mike Knox is finished with professional wrestling.
No!
I apologize. Yes, he likes Mike Knox because he has a beard.
It's epic. You can't not like him.
The reason why he is completely finished is because he is still depressed when he got released from WWE, and he has not been accepting anything that involves professional wrestling.
That emo.
Yeah, he's 33 years old. He'll get over it.
I don't care.
He's having a midlife crisis. Leave him alone.
Leave him alone.
Oh, my God.
Stupid computer going to sleep.
It's not going to sleep. It's just blacking out. And former WWF and TNA superstar Road Dogg, a.k.a. BG James, is a class.
I don't know any of these people.
Is set to return to WWE, but is he going to be a wrestler? I don't know. I mean, I read about what he was going to be, and his chances of being a wrestler in WWE are pretty slim. So
why am I here?
Why are you here?
Yes.
For some of this, because there's some stuff you would talk about in this.
All right.
And any stuff on that, even though you don't know who he is?
Not really.
Minus that his name is spelled R-O-A-D-D-O-G-G. Anything about that?
No.
Okay, you can say it next news article, because I'm talking too much.
It appears that Gregory Helms is on a slow recovery from a motorcycle accident back in May, and I've heard that he is now no longer using crutches.
Yes, because earlier this year, he's had multiple surgeries to where he almost lost his foot because of his accident.
Well, that would have completely destroyed everything.
Yes, because that basically destroys his finisher. His finisher is called the Shining Wizard, and it involves his foot, basically.
Actually, it involves his knee.
I see him using his feet.
You shutting back up.
And, okay. Now, Mr. Vance Archer, Woot Woot, a.k.a. Lance Hoyt, states that if the time was right, he would return to the WWE.
What does he mean by
that? Thank goodness. Basically, if WWE calls him and says they want him back, he's going to go back.
That's funny.
He states that he would have been a main eventer, I agree with him because he destroyed the entire ECW roster. Doesn't I don't care if he destroyed. I don't care who was on the roster. Ezekiel Jackson is nothing compared to Vance Archer.
Let's just calm down.
I'm just saying. Oh my god. And
no, wait, I'm next.
No, we have one more.
No.
Reason being of his release was because he was told of financial reasons. Then again, don't buy what Mr. McMahon says. Anyways, go on with the results of Monday Night Raw.
All right. The
results.
October 10th edition of Raw, correct?
I guess.
All right. John Morrison defeated Christian. Not really sure. I don't remember how any of this went. But I'm just telling you.
He just looked it up.
Okay.
I'm just going by news also.
Randy Orton defeated the world's fattest man, Mark Henry.
The nipple smother.
All right. Via disqualification.
And after the match...
Cody Rhodes is like, hey, I'm going to put a paper bag on your head.
And act like a psychotic freak.
Someone just needs to get in there and shoot him in the neck.
Yes.
Like...
Ding. Yeah, so there's friction growing between the former legacy teammates.
Mason Ryan.
Yes, Mason Ryan.
Ryan. And Air Boom.
Kofi Kingston.
And Evan Bourne, I believe.
Yes, it is.
Defeat... Dolph Ziggler, Jack Swagger, and David Otunga, who I have just now nicknamed the Disgusting Rapscallions.
Why the Disgusting Rapscallions?
Because they just irritate me.
Okay. I'm going to call Dolph Nikki because he used to be on the Spirit Squad.
Yeah, that's fine.
I'm going to call Jack Swagger the something to do with the lisp. I think it's something good that involves saying the word in the lisp. Actually, who cares? He's just a nobody.
Okay.
And
next up, we have Alberto Del Faggot.
Yeah.
And CM Punk.
Straight Edge.
Yes. Versus the Awesome Truth.
Faggots.
I'd say the match was pretty retarded.
Yeah, because...
Alberto Del Rio just tucks his tail and runs.
Like a scalded dog.
And then...
Triple H is like,
here, let me save you, CM Punk.
He's no longer CEO, in case you guys don't know.
Yeah, he got relieved. Sort of like going to the bathroom. It doesn't take...
Just not like that all the way.
All right.
The Vengeance match card. This is what we think is going to happen, but we're not sure. Actually, there's like two matches on here we're not sure about.
This is just our predictions.
Well, two of them is actually going to happen, but who cares? Anyways.
The first match is John Cena versus Alberto Del...
Fact.
Alright, good job. For the WWE Championship. And for some reason, there's a C next to Alberto Del Rio's
that
name.
That says he's the champion.
Oh.
And to be honest, neither of us are not really a big John Cena fan. He's despised him. I'm just like, hey, John Cena, what the heck?
But John Cena is better than Del Rio.
Yeah, that's what we're trying to prove our point here. And now the next match is one of the questionable matches.
Mark Henry, the World Heavyweight Champion for SmackDown, versus Big Show or Randy Orton?
For the World Heavyweight title, of course.
That's what I just said.
All right. So, when I looked this up at first, it said Mark Henry versus the Big Show. And then turns around and it says, oh wait, Orton wins a Battle Royal and now he has a world title shot. Which I'm like, is it Orton or is it Big Show or is it both of them? I'm just like, I don't know.
Now, something else that could happen would be Cody Rhodes going against Randy Orton.
Yes, if this were to happen, then that means the Big Show is going up against Mark Henry, because either way...
And then it seems the Big Show is going to beat Mark Henry, in my mind.
I don't see that happening, because Mark Henry's going to have a long reign, because he's about to retire.
I don't care
and
what he's doing.
And the last match that has recently been updated, to be honest, we didn't catch Friday Night SmackDown.
I did.
Of course you did. And somehow with your magical telephone over there.
I forgot Triple H and CM Punk versus the Awesome Truth.
I was about to state that.
Oh.
Yes, the Awesome Truth The Miz, the underwear model of his own reality show, and the worst rapper in the world, R-Truth, is going against CM Punk and Triple H.
Two of my favorite wrestlers.
Yeah, Triple H.
Yeah, he's all right. All right.
And there's also a possible rumor that John Morrison is leaving the WWE.
That's interesting.
Yes, he doesn't know anything about John Morrison.
Not really.
To me, if he
used to be Johnny Nitro.
Yeah, he just learned that this weekend. Yep. But to me, if he leaves WWE, WWE is making a big mistake. Because he is pretty awesome. He's like fly across the arena.
He has some pretty cool ankles.
He has some pretty cool ankles?
Yes.
Because the little fuzzy thingies?
Yeah.
We can do brush your hair with it?
I wish I could. Send you rad.
Alright, here's some WWE 2012 video game information. I am not sure this is set in, but rumor has it that Randy Orton is to have his beard as an alternate attire in the video game. My opinion, that is freaking retarded.
Calm down, Mike.
Then state your opinion about it.
I really don't care. I actually like him with the beard.
Okay.
And I would like the chance to play as him with the beard and without the beard.
You...
With different colored trunks, of course. That way.
We can do that easily. They have the...
You know what, you can shut it.
I'm trying to explain it, anyways. And big news, we haven't seen the video yet, but Brock Lesnar is in WWE 2012, and he is a legend.
Yeah.
We're kind of marking out about that in our minds right now, because if we were to mark out, the entire house would be screaming at us to shut up. And the reason why this has happened is because I have looked into more information on it. He has signed a new deal with WWE to appear on their video games. I say, about freaking time. And now, here's a topic for you guys to talk about.
Chris Benoit.
Should he be acknowledged in the WWE? At least at all, instead of him being, like, an omen.
Omen?
Because everyone's like, ooh, he killed his wife and kid, he's an omen. When the entire investigation clearly shows that somebody killed them.
Okay.
I think just, you gotta look into it, that's just it. But anyways, comment below on that. If you think Chris Benoit should be acknowledged in the WWE, that may start a humongous argument, but I really don't care.
You will.
And JBL and... Or Mick Foley, actually, either way, I think they're both going to come back in the first place. They may return to WWE.
JBL just got fired.
When? Actually, wait, no, that was, no, that was like 3 years ago, dude. No, he retired 3 years ago.
No, who was the dude that just got fired the other night?
JBL hasn't been in WWE.
Like the one guy with the cowboy hat, he got fired. The fat guy.
Fat guy with the cowboy hat. Who is, nope.
I thought it was JBL. I guess
JBL is sick. He's not fat. He's huge. Like 6'6 and 280.
Well, there's like this fat guy who seems to own a rodeo. And he got fired on Raw the other night.
Why did he get fired?
Because he was one of the first to walk out in Triple H's vote of no confidence.
That was Jim Ross.
Yeah, Jim Ross, that's right.
Yeah, I was ticked off about that.
JBL.
And JBL, yeah. Just so you know, he's been retired since 2009.
Neither of them are the GM of Raw. We've got Laurinaitis now.
Well, it's a rumor.
Yeah, well, it's not going to
happen. I thought it was Johnny Ace at first. Well, we're kind of going through this kind of fast, but who cares? And Kevin Nash is set to return to the WWE after filming his movie. The movie name, we have no freaking clue.
We're not even sure if he's really filming a movie. I think Mike just pulled this out of his butthole.
No, I actually looked this up on the internet.
Okay.
And now, this is another possible rumor. There's like tons of rumors on this freaking thing. I bet half of them aren't even true. WWE may have a scramble match as Survivor Series. Wow. I had to sit there and explain it to him what a scramble match was.
Well, I already know what it was. I mean, I've seen one before.
Alright. And the match may consist of Sheamus, Mark Henry, Christian, Randy Orton, The Big Show, and Kane.
Does Raw not get a championship scramble?
It's probably going to be CM Punk and Alberto.
At Survivor Series?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Probably, because...
Because the Cena's going to be out of the picture.
Because what are Cena and Rock doing exactly?
They're teaming up. They're probably going to be on a team at Survivor Series. Like
against
a five,
who?
Maybe five other guys. And it's going to be Cena and The Rock and three other people against five other guys. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
But yes, who are you rooting for in that match if that were to happen?
Which match?
The scramble match.
For SmackDown?
Yes.
Probably Christian or Randy Orton. More likely Randy Orton. I want him as my heavyweight champion.
Well, Randy Orton's probably not going to get it back for a while.
You can suck it.
Hey, I'm not saying because he's not going to get it. I'm just saying because I'm using my knowledge well enough. Because I've watched it longer than you have.
Let me smack you in the face.
Do with it.
Not
with a dog in the way.
My dog's in the way. I can't smack you.
Get your bad boy. I would probably personally be rooting for Randy Orton or Sheamus. Because I'm starting to like Sheamus a little bit.
I still hate him.
Because he's Irish. You have something against Irishmen.
Not really.
All right.
They're just like, hey, I'll give you a pot of gold. Ha, I lied. I raped your wife.
Funny. That was probably the biggest insult you've ever done all week.
Yeah.
And recently,
Brock Lesnar.
Brock Lesnar has been in an interview over his video game status and his possible chance of going back to WWE.
Which would be pretty cool.
Yes, he said if the time was right, he would return to the WWE. Your opinion?
I really don't care what he does.
Yes,
honestly.
He just saw Brock Lesnar in action over the weekend because I showed him a DVD with him in there.
I'm kind of half and half on him right now.
Why is that? Because of his eyebrows?
Yes. I just hate his eyebrows.
You love his...
I like his fighting style, but when it comes to his eyebrows, he just needs to get out.
Just get over it. He's not going to dye his eyebrows black.
Isn't he?
And rumor has it, which is kind of shocked me. I guess he has issues with The Undertaker. Who has issues with The Undertaker?
Everybody.
Nobody does.
Paul Bearer does.
Undertaker is the most respected guy in the business. Who?
True.
Nope, I'm just surprised. And this also shocked me. Brock Lesnar stated this. If I were to have gotten in the ring with him, I would have ripped his arm off and...
Beep.
Beeping, beat him with it. That basically threw that rumor of Brock Lesnar versus Undertaker last year at WrestleMania out the window. Sorry, folks. I'm kind of surprised at that. I'm serious.
And Stone Cold gets pissed.
Yes. Brock Lesnar made some comments in his interview that kind of threw Stone Cold over the limit. Basically, what happened was Brock Lesnar was asked the question if there was anybody he would want to wrestle in the WWE, who would it be? And he basically said Stone Cold Steve Austin because Stone Cold basically took his ball and left, and he thought Brock Lesnar was too much of a threat or a danger to Stone Cold.
That's pretty much of a...
Yeah, Stone Cold has... I mean, I love Stone Cold the wrestler, but he just had so many issues in the past.
That's interesting.
Yeah, it's just...
Alright.
And...
Maybe they could have a match in the future.
I highly doubt it, but I kind of hope...
Why is it on the paper?
Well, it's kind of a dream match hope for the future, but then again, it's like... Stone Cold's not going to come back. Brock Lesnar's not going to come back probably within the next 4 years. Stone Cold's probably going to be...
Dead?
No. Probably not even to where he can't even get in the ring anymore. Because of his knees are bad. Just like mine.
Yep, that's pretty sad.
Yeah, and that's basically about it.
Yeah, but now we have tonight's edition of SmackDown. October 15th.
Yes, you want to talk about that since information? If you can
I don't have it on me, but
have it memorized?
Pretty much.
Talk, my friend.
So, I've read that there was quite an epic match tonight. One which took place with 41 men in the same ring for a battle royal match for a number one contender spot for...
The World Heavyweight or WWE title.
Yes. It seems that Randy Orton came out as the victor on that match. Not really surprised, but
yeah.
Hey, that's the way things happen. So, Randy Orton went against Mark Henry for his World Heavyweight Championship.
And guess who comes out?
Cody Rhodes.
That faggot.
Okay, he's getting ready to put a bag on Orton's head again, which is just, no.
It's like high school all over again.
Those high school rapscallions.
Stupid idiots.
Anyway, before he does that, Big Show comes out and kind of lambasts Cody Rhodes. And so, I'm thinking here.
I think he chokeslams Mark Henry.
Yeah, Big Show chokeslams Mark Henry.
Through a table?
And then... Or is it... No, it was just chokeslam.
Oh.
But then Big Show helps set up Randy Orton for an RKO to Cody Rhodes, and they both...
Partied
after the match.
Yeah.
We'll say that.
Does Cody Rhodes have that face mask?
I don't know. I haven't seen any pictures of him.
If he still has that face mask, I'm be like, why does he have that? He's had it for a whole year. He doesn't need it anymore.
All right. Anyway.
Because a nose injury doesn't last that long.
Anything else? I'm pretty... There are a few Divas match tonight. As well as a tag team match, which I really don't care about.
Which was it?
It was Zack Ryder and Kofi Kingston. Now, Zack Ryder was filling in for...
Evan Bourne.
On the tag team, Air Boom.
Air Boom, yeah.
And they went against Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger for the what appears to be the 10th time in the past few months. I think they would. I didn't really pay attention
to
that.
It's like Mason Ryan, Zack Ryder, Kofi Kingston, and Evan Bourne are like always fighting Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger.
Well, they are kind of fake.
Yeah, and Otunga got thrown into it last week because of Mason Ryan.
Yeah.
But I'm just glad that they're finally using Mason Ryan, and hopefully he's better than Botulism, a.k.a. Batista. That's my new nickname for him.
All right. Well, that's actually all I remember for now.
Yes, and we really have nothing else to talk about because we can go on and on and on, but we don't want to.
Yeah, it'd just be kind of boring for you guys.
Yeah, so that is all. Sorry for no news of the week or interview time. Blame the wrestling news. And this is...
Harvey Beardman, signing off.
I'm sorry you don't get to see the...
The horse stroking of the beard.
Because the stupid camera is just stupid. And you will... Anyways, I'm getting nowhere with this.
Yeah, just...
Jerbatron 5000 MV1, signing off. V.1. You feel me?